Before I start, including the microphone test, technology is good. Yesterday, we had rehearsal. It's been perfect. Wearing my favorite shirt, then I drank coffee. Guess what? I spilled coffee in my shirt. What do you think I did next? A, I gave my shirt to my assistant, then he can go down to a river, send very cold water, repeatedly beat the shirt again, again, again. Or, did I use a piece of technology specifically designed for one purpose? Washing machine. Of course I used a washing machine, and my assistant was very happy. Now, we don't think of the washing machine as innovative technology. We don't say, oh, washing machine, taking jobs away from all the people who chose their career to go down to the river to beat the shots against rocks. Who wants to do that? No one. Professor Cardia says, the washing machine had a gigantic effect on women's lives around the world. It freed up time for women to enter the workforce. Turning out the washing machine are feminist. Freedom comes when you can automate. Now, what is automation? How is it different from AI? One way to look at it is AI mimics human's brain, analysis, and judgment. Automation focuses on streamlining processes. Then there's RPA, robotic process automation. It's a new automation. Software acts like human to streamline processes. AI thinking, RPA is doing. Combines those two, you can make what we call digital robot. Why is automation with digital robot important for everyone? Firstly, working population is declining in Japan. But more importantly, there's a mismatch of talent. In Japan, year 2030, there was a surplus of 1.2 million clerical workers, shortage of 1.7 million skilled professionals. We have so many separate systems. Humans have to interface between them. It's tedious, complicated, frustrating manual work. But it looks like a machine work. I believe everyone should have a digital robot so we can transform society at all levels. With digital robot, enable people to be less like machines and to be more human. We can do more idea work, creative work, social work by freeing up our time. You don't even need programming skills. All you really need is empathy. As a CEO of a company, working with AI, RPA, and digital robot, I am often asked, what's the future of robot? It's not like Logie from Jetsons. No, not your servant. It's not like a Terminator, not your enemies. The future of robot is like Doraemon. This is Japanese anime character. Doraemon is your friend. if you are very clear what you want him to do, I'm giving him dorayaki, Japanese pancake, he's going to help you out. He'll be your reliable friend. If you work closely, giving him the right expectation, he's going to bring new inventions from his pocket. Those inventions are like AI, like translation software in your computer. It's Doraemon's honyaku konnyaku, translation jelly. Eat it, language barrier is gone. So I ate it 20 minutes ago. So I can speak English with Japanese accent. The only difference between Doraemon and digital robot is the digital robot is invisible software. Doraemon has a body. Now, let me talk about some of the potential of digital robot. In July, we had an RPA and AI workshop for school students. They played around with digital robot. Two of students said that, wow, we have to use robot to help our teacher, our favorite teacher. I'm curious, how? Our teacher is miserable. She has to go to the office very early in the morning, stays very late to prepare and grade quiz. A teacher's influence affects the future. Imagine, teachers don't have to step up all night to prepare to score test. Teachers can focus on individual students, thus they need attention. Attention to the people is so important. Mr. Yamada, he works as a financial consultant for a prestigious bank. Oh, by the way, this one doesn't like Mr. Yamada, though. In any case, he used to wake up 5 a.m. in the morning, rush to the office, get the overnight financial update, prepare, reconcile, then all the work. Then he drinks coffee. Spit on his shirt, but he has no assistant to go to the river. Now, Mr. Yamada and his colleagues create a robot, streamlining all his processes while he sleeps. Every night, 100 robots work for Mr. Yamada and 3,000 financial consultants. Read a consultant calendar, identify customer meeting schedule, prepare the customer's latest financial information, make recommendation, send an email. What do you think? The 3,000 financial consultants lose their jobs to digital robot? No. They have more time, focus, and attention to create relationship. Customers are very happy, so as Mr. Yamada. 2018 was a disaster-filled year for West Japan. Landslides, typhoons, heavy rains. In case of heavy rain, 18,000 houses were affected. In those situations, insurance companies want to go in as soon as possible and assess damage and make a payment to the family in need. We provided digital robot, saved 38,000 work hours of processing manual paperwork. In Within 2 days, the victims of disaster had their payout. While robots are working on farms, insurance employees are caring for the people suffering. This comes from our belief system. When we are handcuffed by manual work, we lose capacity to be human. By automating work, empathy emerges. Work in the field like automation, we tend to get lost in a technology. I believe digital transformation has to be human-based. In this case, digital robots are only a tool. Innovation is not only coming from genius programmers in Silicon Valley. The key is you, making robot with empathy, bringing the innovation from the ground, small improvement, simple improvement, amplified by the technology like digital robot. That leads to innovation. We say, Genba ni kami yadoru in Japanese. The best idea comes from frontline. Earlier, I talked about the future of mismatch in Japan in 2030. If we taught people to use empathy to build robot, how that could change the future of Japan and the world. Thank you.